your back on retirement and get back to work. That's what former business secretary Sir Vince Cable is telling the fittest of retirees to do.
Yeah, he suggested we should get the elderly back into jobs to tackle budget deficits and public debt. Do you agree? We've been finding out.
I've earned my right to retirement. I'm 71. And, you know, how long does he want us to work for? Don't we deserve to have a few years off?
No, I won't, because I'm tired and I feel tired already.
Yes, if some lovely project came my way, I would love to go back to work.
You work hard enough, you've earned your pension. I left my job because of the pandemic, and I am saving the country money by not getting ill.
I don't mind going back to work, it doesn't bother me at all. I'm fit and healthy, I can do it. But apart from owing society money, we've paid in.
Well, there you go. Mm. So, what do you think? Should retirees be sent back into the workforce? Well, joining us is former apprentice contestant Ryan Mark Parsons, who thinks anyone who can work should. And journalist Nina Myskow, who says older people have earned the right to retire and shouldn't be forced to continue. Now, Nina, I'm not sure you're a good example of that argument because you are older, let's put it that way, and you're
still... 75.
You're 75, there you go, and you still do lots and lots of work. So you are somebody who's fit and does enjoy working.
It's true. I'm very, very lucky. I'm capable of working, and I'm very lucky that I have the sort of job that I enjoy doing and that I can continue to do, and I will continue to do that until I drop, which I'm sure will annoy a lot of people, but there you go. The problem is saying to people, you know, you're fit and healthy, you're over 66, get back to work. That's just not right. Mm. People have earned the right. People have earned the right to put their feet up, do whatever they want. But the idea that older people are sitting by their second home swilling champagne is far from the truth. You know, the economy would absolutely collapse if older people stopped doing the unpaid job that they are doing, which is babysitting. If they stopped doing this unpaid job, then the entire economy would collapse.
That's very true. That's very true, isn't it, Ryan Mark Parsons? We all know about granny daycare. Grandparents all over the world are picking up the slack of mums and dads who have to work longer and can't be at home in the way that perhaps people did in the past. Or aren't able to be around as much. And not only that, very often older people who've retired are carers for partners and other members in the family, and beyond that, have worked very hard, paid their taxes in all sorts of different roles in jobs, and have perhaps earned the retire to take care of themselves and look after their health and pace themselves a little bit more in retirement.
Well, you know what? I think it's a great thing that the elderly are getting into work, whether that is caring, if they are looking after family members, etc. But I think there's also an opportunity for the elderly, if you're over a certain age, over 60. I'm 21. I'm a long time away from being that old. But I can say that if you are that age, you could not only be a carer, but you could be a freelance business person. You could be a delivery man or woman. There's loads of opportunities out there for the elderly to get up and switch off Coronation Street, the catch up on ITV Hub, and get out and work. That's what I would say. And in terms of generating money for the economy, get a job that pays and help boost what we're dealing with at the moment in terms of the UK economy, where more and more elderly could be getting into employment, whether that's staying in a job that they already have or going back to work, learning a new skill and reducing that inflation that Vince Cable was talking about in his article and the public deficit.
Nina, come on. They can go out and be delivery drivers. And look, we've got ITV Hub, so they're not going to miss Coronation Street, says
Ryan. Well, exactly. The idea that people are lying on the sofa watching telly is outrageous. And you know, delivery drivers, HGV drivers, you know, farm workers picking, you know, let's see where are their gaps in the economy. HGV drivers, farm workers, et cetera, et cetera. That's carers. They're doing that already. And the basic principle is also people who have paid in over all these years have earned the right. If they want to lie on the sofa watching Coronation Street, I wouldn't advise it, because you need to keep yourself healthy and move around, you know, as well as watching telly. You know, it's just outrageous that having paid in all this money, you should be able to reap the benefits. That's what it's for. I have been paying taxes for 55 years. You know, how long have you been paying taxes for? Is it 2 years? You know, you may be the youngest person, The Apprentice, but you've been paying taxes for how long? 2 years?
Nina, you're making excuses for elderly being lazy. Let me tell you.
I'm not being lazy.
Let me tell you this.
Lazy?
Conducted this.
Define lazy.
900,000 elderly people over the age of 60 returned to work as a result of the pandemic. And one in 10 of over 70s, if they return to work or if they get a new job, they would generate around £1.8 billion for the economy. So do you not see that as a good thing? Or do you want the elderly to be strolling around Brighton
Beach? I think if people can find a job, if they can do a job, then that's absolutely fine, and that is their choice. But the point being, it is not something that should be forced upon them. If they have paid in for all these years, they have earned the right to take back from the system. Explain to me how many years. Tell me how many years you've been paying in taxes.
Well, I've been working since the age of 16, so I'm now 21.
How long have you been paying taxes for?
Well, since the age of 16, when I had a job.
So that's 5 years.
He's 21.
I'm 21.
So 5 years. So set that against 55 years, 40 years of national insurance. I have helped to support the older generation. I have helped to support the middle generation. I have been supporting. I am now supporting you. We are a society. We all help each other.
Okay,
to say that older people are lazy is absolutely outrageous.
It's your generation that is heavily reliant upon expansive healthcare services, which is costly. And if you're not contributing to any tax, pressure on
I am contributing. I am contributing personally. And the reason you pay in. I'm sorry, I cannot hear a word you're saying.
Mark, finish, Nina. Just pause for a second. Sorry, Mark. What was your point? We lost you there. We lost you there, Mark. Say again.
Right. I was saying that the young people have a lot of pressure. Okay, Nina can try and demonise me and patronise me for not paying taxes as long as her. Well, she's a lot older. Of course, she's going to she's had more time to pay taxes. But what I'm saying is there's a lot of pressure on young people like me to fork the bill for the expansive healthcare services that the elderly require. There's a higher dependency. And if they're not working, they're not paying national insurance, it's on the younger people to fork the bill when there's squeezing when it comes to school and college budgets.
The problem is, though, Ryan Mark, is what Nina would say is she forked the bill for the people older than her, and there will be another generation forking the bill for you.
You know what, Kate? I think it's a case, as I said earlier, of laziness. Look at the Queen. She's 95 years old. She gets up, she goes to work, and she does so much for this country. I can even speak about Lord Sugar. He's 74.
Have it.
And I think comparisons to the Queen, Ryan Mark, are a bit different. I mean, she's quite reasonably wealthy compared to a lot of other people. But can I just ask something? You're now 21. Are you saying, Ryan Mark, that you are prepared to work into your 80s and retirement should be not even an option for your generation? So you will continue working for another 65 years and you'll never be able to retire and enjoy any sort of pleasure of retirement? Is that what you're saying?
That is what I'm saying. I'm going to work until I drop. I think it's a really good attitude and working mentality to just have the sort of resilience to get up in the morning, put your boots on, go to work. And I'd love to see more grannies on the tube. I think it's a great thing.
Hang on a minute. That's a very responsible attitude to say you'll keep on working, and that's absolutely fine. I have kept on working, and I'll continue to do so. But I defend to the death the right of people who have paid into the system to stop at the age of retirement. Otherwise, why do we have a retirement age? You know, the thing is, you are 21. You're a grown-up boy. You take responsibility. Stop whining about the older generation. Take responsibility. Live your life. Earn your money, pay in for the rest of us, and we will pay in for you. We will continue to do so when we can. But it does not it does just not fit right for you to say that the older generation are lazy.
Okay.
That is absolutely an insult I will not take.
All right. Well,
just because they've earned the right to stop working at the official age of 66.
Okay,
what's
well,
wrong
look, I tell you what, Nina and Ryan Mark, you've sparked a debate for us this morning. Very interesting to hear your different points of view. Good to talk to both of you. We've already had people commenting, haven't we?
Yeah, I'm...
Are you kidding? And this is a woman after my own heart, says Sarah. Forced to work after retirement, I'm shattered at 59. I think that's how a lot of people feel, don't they?
Exactly. A lot of people saying this. Kale on email, it's not the elderly that needs to work, it's our young generation that need to get off gadgets and get out and work. That was Nina Myskow, by the way, journalist and apprentice contestant Ryan Mark Parsons.